Good day, everybody. You already know my name. I am teacher Eduardo Sosa Castillo. I am your civics and ethics teacher. And today I am here for you to show you a video that is going to talk about the different secretaries of our country. We are going to watch this video to talk about this important topic. Let's start with the first institution, that in this case it's SEGOV. SEGOV means Secretaría de Gobernación. I'm going to start telling you what are the most important activities that Secretaría de Gobernación does. First, the first one is that SEGOV usually has meetings with each state secretaries to make agreements. So, as you can see, SEGOV usually has many reunions with all the secretaries of the different states of the Republic, and altogether they make agreements in benefit of the country. They also present to the Union Congress all the laws that the president has proposed. In this case, the president proposes different modifications to the constitution or some proposals that he has for the benefit of the country. And SEGOV gives all these proposals to the Union Congress, and the Union Congress decides if they pass or if they are rejected. The next thing they do is that they make international treaties. They make treaties with other countries so that our country Mexico can have better relationships of commerce, tourism, and other important things that bring money to the country. The other thing that SEGOV does is to coordinate the state, municipal, and federal authorities. So, as you can see, the role of SEGOV is very important because they help to coordinate all the most important powers of our nation: the power of the state, the power of the municipality, and the federal authorities. And the last thing that SEGOV does is to make deals to collaborate between the government and private companies. So as you can see, SEGOV is a very important intermediate between the important private companies and the government. The other Mexican institution that we are going to check today is the SRE, that in this case it means Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores. As you can see, the man of the picture is Licenciado Marcelo Ebrard. He is in charge of this institution. And these are the activities that Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores does. First, they promote Mexico's tourism and commerce all around the world. The second thing is that they give permission to other countries to exploit natural resources. As you know, Mexico is a country that has a lot of natural resources, and some other countries from around the world, they are interested in exploring these resources, and obviously most of the time is a benefit for the country because it brings a better economy and creates more jobs. The next thing is that they deal with other nations in criminal problems related with Mexicans abroad. In this case, sometimes there are Mexicans who live in other countries, and when they have some kind of problem with the authorities of another country, Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores intervenes to help to solve this problem that Mexicans have in other country. They also deal with any issue that has to do with naturalization and nationality. This institution has the power to give them the Mexican nationality to people from other countries, and is in charge of regulating and managing all the papers that can be necessary to naturalize a person from another country who wants to become Mexican or who wants to become a Mexican citizen and a person that wants to live in our country. Finally, they make the other countries respect the territory limits that our country has. You know that Mexico is not just the land territory, it's also the ocean and the islands that Mexico has. So, Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores has to look for some alternatives to make that the other countries respect the limits that our country has. The next institution that I'm going to tell you, it's SEDENA. SEDENA means Secretaría de la Defensa Nacional. These are the different activities that SEDENA does. First of all, let's start by saying that the person in charge of SEDENA is Luis Sandoval. As you can see in the picture, he is an important general. He used to be a soldier. And SEDENA is in charge of managing and preparing the army and the navy. In this case, the army and the navy are institutions that are directly in charge of SEDENA. They also plan and manage military intervention around the country in cases necessary. SEDENA decides if the army can intervene in all the country when it's necessary, so that they can help the police officers, and if the government considers necessary, the army and the navy can start helping authorities like the police officers for problems like crime, drug dealing, and some other issues that our country has. Manage military hospital and stay in military barracks, as well as build places for the navy or the army. In this case, you know that some of the best doctors that we have in our country are military doctors. So, in this case, SEDENA is in charge of managing all these doctors so that they can be for our country. Something important whenever it's necessary and whenever they are required. SEDENA also manages the Air Force, education, and execution. So, all the people who want to be a pilot from the Air Force, SEDENA is in charge of teaching them and educating them. And also, they are in charge of the airplanes and everything that has to do with the Air Force. The next thing is to check the correct use and distribution of weapons. As you can see, in Mexico, it's a country that where we can buy weapons illegally. So SEDENA is in charge of supervising that all the weapons that enter to our country, or that are being sold, or that are possessed by some people, they get them in a legal way. Because it's important to have a control of all these weapons so that people don't use it for bad purposes. And the last thing is to help the citizens in case there are emergency. When we are talking about an emergency, we are talking about, for example, natural phenomena like hurricanes, earthquakes, for example, floods, when it rains a lot. SEDENA is in charge of helping Mexican people whenever there is an emergency like that. Now it's time to take a look at Secretaría de Educación Pública, that in this case we call it SEP. Secretaría de Educación Pública is controlled by Licenciado Esteban Moctezuma Barragán. You can see it in the picture. And he manages and develops all public schools incorporated to SEP. So, as you can see, SEP is in charge of supervising all these schools that are incorporated to SEP, because not all the schools are incorporated to SEP. Only in this case, UNAM and Poly, they are considered independent. The next thing is to give a scholarship and support students who want to study in another country. If a student wants to study in another country, or if you are a very good student, SEP can help you with some money and some support so that you can keep on going with your studies. Also, SEP is in charge of managing and conserving museums, monuments, ruins, and historical sites and everything inside those places. So as you can see, SEP has a very big responsibility because he's in charge of these places and everything that it's inside these places. Also, it's in charge of promoting science development and investigation in the school and in different institutions. They are also in charge of checking the school and to make sure that all people can be educated, because you know that education is a constitutional right. And finally, they are in charge of planning activities for the school year, like, for example, meetings with teachers, courses for the teachers, and finally to promote sports and arts in all the school institutions. Finally, let's take a look at double S, that in this case it's Secretaría de Salud. Now it's a very important institution now that we are facing a health crisis due to COVID-19. You can see that Secretaría de Salud, that is preceded by Dr. José Carlos Alcocer, that actually he used to be a doctor. This institution is in charge of regulating everything that has to do with medicines, medical supplies, vaccines, and distribution of them. So it's not just that I can sell medicines. Secretaría de Salud is in charge of checking them and regulating them. Also, is in charge of managing and supervising private and public health institutions all over Mexico. They are in charge of supervising these hospitals and also to make sure that all the people have the right to get healthcare. Because now, thanks to the president and the Congress, now health, it's a right that every Mexican has in the Constitution. And they also are in charge of creating strategies and methods to have a correct action during the national health crisis. Like now with COVID-19, they are designing what is the best strategy so that not too many people can get sick of COVID-19, and what are the measurements that we have to follow. Finally, we have to regulate measures related to health, everything that has to do with health and the best way to take care of it. And finally, they have to make sure that people have money for their retirement. So these were the five institutions that I explained today, that in this case are Secretaría de Salud, SEP, SEDENA, SRE, Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores, SEGOV. These are the different secretaries of our country. Thanks for watching this video and get ready for the next activity that I'm going to publish in classroom. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.